Hi guys, welcome to the channel. In this one we're just going to be going for a nice little ride. See where it takes us. I haven't planned on going anywhere, but yeah, it's breaking the weather. And it's not so cold, not so rainy now, but it is cold. So yeah, just going to have a little ride around and take you guys with me. So enjoy the ride and thanks for everyone tuning back in. Thanks for all the new viewers and appreciate it. So enjoy the ride. Tell you what, definitely feel the cold kicking in. I haven't got the gloves on today, just got some normal bike gloves on really. So yeah. I will be getting out the heated gloves pretty soon, I'd imagine. Let's see, today's more like a little test ride for my hands really. See if the old fingers get a bit cold. We'll just open her up a little bit, warm her up. E-bike, you know, always on a normal mountain bike, but yeah, never really, I wouldn't say enjoyed it because I just love getting out on the bike. This is a different level, I'll tell you. I wonder if you look after you. Your bike and your battery and that. So you can go for a long old time. I've been rocking this battery now for like 2.5 years. It's only dropped like a small percentage. So still going strong. Of other YouTubers, and someone was just mentioning about the distance you can cover in a short period of time. It's absolutely spot on. Adventure machine, if you like. You want to get out, you know, go and enjoy the day. Get a breeze in there. This is not stock. I'm riding around on a BBS HD, and yeah, I just changed out the controller. And the cog inside, change it to a gear. It just means that the cog can take a higher temperature, but nothing too fancy. And still receiving basically, you know, a good amount of power. I'm thinking about a couple of things I want to do. One of them is I've got some batteries left over from the previous battery build I did. So I've done one in the beginning and then had to loan that out to my friend. He was in desperate need and he's now got his own battery, so I've got that battery back. And basically I think there's all those batteries just sitting there that are in good condition. I had a few extras left over, so I think I might have a crack at making maybe a 60 volt battery of 18650 cells. I've been watching some other YouTubers, one in particular, he's really getting good at building batteries, man. It makes them look effortlessly easy, which is it's good. It's just a good thing. It's a DIY. It's all about DIY for me. So, I mean, if I can do it, you can do it. So I'm going to have a crack at doing one of them, I think. And the other project is my friend wants to get a 3000 watt hub motor, possibly with a far driver controller and 72 watt battery. I don't know if he wants us to make a battery or buy the battery outright, but I know he's definitely after more power. So we're going to see Dave and have a think about what he wants exactly, and then we'll see. But whatever I do, I'll definitely be filming it. Thank you. So hopefully a couple of things in the pipeline to sort out. Life. through that. Careful, because the old leaves on the floor. See a bit of greenery on the floor. See what I mean? It's just tapping the brake. Uphill here, I don't know if you can tell on the vid. Yeah. What I tend to do is just power off to get away from the motors and that, especially when they're creeping up on you. That bloody van. I don't know if you can tell, but this is a very steep hill here, really. Actually, what I'll see if I can do here. Let's see if... I always forget to do this. I'm just going to basically link this up. Alright, one sec. Alright, so now I've put the GPS on, so you... I'll get the, see if I've got the slope on this, and I can't remember. Symbol on the back, but they're all wearing the same stuff. Now, I'm not trying to push it hard up this hill, just an example, and I was just using throttle then, to be honest. I'll use the pedals as well, just to show you. basically, you know, anything with 1,000 watts, maybe a little bit less actually, who knows, I've not really tried anything less than well, 1,000 watts, which is bigger, you know, it's like my mom, but I've upgraded it so it's a little bit more juicy. But yeah, imagine the same 1,000 watts will pull you up a hill, and I've yet to see whether the other stuff can do a good job really. I don't think a 250 will pull you up something like this. It's too steep and too long. Peddling your arse off basically to get up here. So what's the point? Might as well just go on the normal bike, gonna do something like that. Especially up a hill like this. Yeah, some, you know what, I'd say maybe a 5 to 750 going to 1,000. That will definitely get you up the hill. And you won't be too out of breath. Anything beyond that, or higher than that, if you like, then you'll get, you know, a different kind of performance. And this is what I love. Save a little bit of battery. Oh, I've got 40 minutes left. That's what it says, I've got like 40 minutes, but I don't know. We will see. Oh, does it? What does it say there? Yeah, 40 minutes. Yeah, normally I poke my cameras out for me. But I just wanted to give the Ace Pro a test on its own really. I'm looking to get in a wireless mic and set that up. I've been going back over some of the footage and it's pretty clear. It's not too much wind distortion or wind noise. Yeah, getting back to the bikes, really. Can't explain it. It's just a load of people talking about it. It's a sense of being a bit free, you know, stuck in a bunch of traffic all the time. And it doesn't make you feel young again, it just gives you that, brings back some joy, you know, when getting out and about. Just for me, what it's all about. sorry if I ramble on in my videos. I'm just trying to emphasise the fact of getting across that anyone, you know, can give this a go and have a load of fun in the process. Lovely day, eh? Okay, I want to go somewhere a little different today. I want to try and see if I can get close to the water. Shut this up and catch you in a second. Yeah, so just come off that roundabout now. It's just that I didn't go on it properly. I just didn't want to take a chance mucking about. Into that side of the pavement. Get all the old leaves coming up the trees. Not yet. This is somewhere in the winter time. Oh my god. Like I said, I've got some other heat gloves. I've got two different pairs. One for it's got really cold. The other one for it's just, you know, really chilly. So, we'll see. To be very careful on floors like this because you start seeing all that green moss everywhere. It's just like that. You're on the air and bang, you're on the floor. like in your part of the world, and this is in the UK, so cold is it getting where you are, or is it even getting cold where you are? You might be sweating. There's the water, I can see the water from here, so basically, why not, let me try down here. This is where I was one time, one mate, Dave. I know where I am now. Just give you guys a quick view of that. Just in case you haven't got a chance in the other videos to see that. You see that? Lovely. So yeah, let's carry on the journey. I'm just trying to get a golf club for it. Yeah, don't. Oh, yeah. Oh, it feels a bit wet here. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's a bit chillier down here, let me tell you. Oh. up a little steep hill. When I'm going downhill, you can hear. Let's get on the pavement. I have no idea where this is. Where the hell is this? Is it in this station there? Oh, it just says Brimfleet Station. Seeing some water here. Really just beside the water, so let's see if I can stay on this route. Choice but to cross over here, so catch you on the other side. this. This is what I'm talking about, guys. I've got another little gym. Bumping, but it's been quite fire, so it's parallel with a golf course out here. Actually, I don't mind if I get a little bit covered today because it's, you know, it's been raining for weeks, man. Heavy as well. And there's only like little gaps in between. So when you're trying to make a bit of content, it's extremely hard to try and make some content because the time it takes you to get yourself sorted out, get it out for a ride, everywhere's so big, mate, anyways. That's annoying. I did check the weather today, obviously, and they said it was going to be half decent, so yeah. That's enough invitation for me. Let's get out of there and make a video. The old stabilisation is coming into play here. Let's stop there for a second. 53, I've got plenty of juice. 40% left on the battery for the camera. I'll give myself a spare battery. So much open land here, it's lovely. Take her up a little bit, guys. Goes on and on. It's magic. Don't hurry up. So far away from the what we're used to. That's awesome. Didn't want to save a little bit for the way home.
Sorry.
It's alright. I don't really have my map at all too much here because my device hit me in the face. Was? I spoke to you too soon. No, I haven't. What is this now? Bloody hell. South Bend on Sea, right? That's awesome. I've never seen it from this side. It's beautiful. Wow. That's that would have probably got here anyways. That would have been the end of the trail.
knows?
Alright, I want to cut it here, guys. I'll try to save a little bit for the way home. Alright, so yeah, not far from home now. So you see, 12%. It looks like this. This is the end of the ride with you guys. So thanks for tuning in back into this channel, and appreciate it very much. And yeah, I'll catch you in the next one. Take care out there, and bye for now.